mystery of the game. Throwing a ball across two persons or two groups of people was a recreational play observed during 1930s in Australia and England. It was accepted as a very popular play during the leisure period, especially by the women. Therefore, basically, this throwball play was known to be as women's game. It is believed that this throwball reached India through YMCA, most probably during 1940s. Initially, this play was restricted to Chennai and later in 1950s reached Bangalore. Dr. H. C. Buck, head of the department YMCA, College of Physical Education, Chennai, formulated preliminary guidelines for the first time during 1955. Almost after 15 years, this play of throwball was auspicious of Throwball Federation of India, TFI, at Bangalore, led by B.M. Rachappa, Director of Physical Education, University of Bangalore. Simultaneously, this play was well accepted at schools and colleges for both boys and girls. T. Ramanna, a humble sports lover and promoter from Bangalore, shouldered the responsibility of organizing a national level throwball championship for the first time at Bangalore during 1980s. Further, a national level organization, TFI, was re-established under the leadership of T. Ramanna, and in the year 1985, draft rules were framed. Ministry of Sports, Government of India, has recognized TFI as national level sports organization in 1989. The game of throwball has been developed and became a popular game among men and women in all the states wide over the country by 1990. Professor Dayanand Aksar, another sports lover and promoter from Gulbarga University, Gulbarga, has edited first copy of rules and regulations of throwball game in 1990s under the directions of T. Ramanna, Secretary General, TFI. The great sports vision of T. Ramanna moved the national level organization TFI to Asian level organization ATF from 1996 onwards, including the countries South Korea, Sri Lanka, Japan, Nepal, Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand, Pakistan, and Bangladesh. In view of the faster development of the game, the second edition of the rules and regulation book and the modified ball was brought by TFI during the year 2000. To promote the game effectively at the international level, T. Ramanna conducted first Asian Throwball Championship at Kolkata during the year 2002 and the second Asian Throwball Championship at Chennai during the year 2005. The indigenous sport vision of T. Ramanna aimed at the world level and established International Throwball Federation, ITF, during August 2002. Chief Officer of ITF is established at Bangalore and the Regional Office for Asian Countries is located at South Korea, where Dr. Lee Jong-young being the Secretary in charge. Several others who are thriving very hard for the development and promotion of the game at international level are Abdul Halim bin Khader, Singapore. In view of the popularity and fast promotion of the game, and to strengthen the game technically sound at the international level. The preset third edition book edited by Professor Dayanand Aksar on game and rules of the throwball of International Throwball Federation is being published by Chief Secretary General ITF Bangalore.
The throwball court. The surface may be made up of grass, wooden, polygrass or hard court. The dimension of the surface of the throwball court. The width shall be 12.20 meters. The line shall be marked with yellow, white or any contrast color with the surface. The length of the court shall be 18.30 meters, marked again with yellow or white color, and the half court measurement shall be 9.15 meters. The service zone shall be 6.10 meters, marked with dotted lines, situated on the right side of the playing area outside the court within the free zone, shall be 12.20 meters. The box line being 1.50 meters on either side of the court, which forms a 3 meters box. The total length shall be 3 meters, which shall be called as neutral zone or the box area, and the zones being marked with dotted lines, and the front zone being 2.55 meters from the box line. The front zone shall be 2.55 meters. The center zone shall be 2.55 meters again, and the back zone also shall be 2.55 meters. The height of the net 2.30 meters. The length of the net being 12.50 meters, on which the playing surface will be 12.20 meters. The width of the net being 1 meter. The antenna being 1.80 meters with 1 meter within the net and 80 centimeters above the net, marked with white and red colors. The height of the pole being 2.30 meters. The pole being 2.30 meters. The diameter of the pole being 10 centimeters. The free zone being 3 meters on all the four sides of the court. The scorer bench being placed outside the free zone, and the substitution bench also being placed outside the free zone. The scorers being seated outside the free zone behind the umpire, and the substitution bench also being placed on the left and right side of the scorers. The scoring board being operated by the scorer. The set score and the match score being projected by the scorer, being assisted by the assistant scorer. Location for the umpire being positioned within the free zone outside the sideline. The position for the assistant or line umpire being situated on the rear side of the service zone. The position of the lights for the matches being played under lights. The height of the pole shall be 20 feet on the minimum side and shall be raised according to the surface. The poles shall be situated on the rear side without affecting the player's eyesight.
Ball. The ball shall be spherical in shape with lemon yellow color and dark green stripes. The ball shall be made up of synthetic leather. The size of the ball shall measure when inflated 70 centimeters circumference. The weight of the ball shall be 450 grams. The ball recognized by ITF and marked so shall only be used during the matches. The pressure of the ball shall be equal to 0.6 to 1.1 atmosphere, which is 100 grams per centimeter square at sea level. Team. The team shall consist of a maximum of 12 members. The playing team shall comprise only 7 players during play. However, substitution up to a maximum of 5 players from 12 member is allowed. But at no point of time, the playing team shall exceed 7 members. A match should not be considered valid if there are less than 7 players in either side of the team. Players' position. The position of the players in the court shall be as follows. Front zone 1 and 2. Center zone 3, 4 and 5. Back zone 6 and 7. The player standing in position 7 shall make the position to serve the ball. The rotation of the position of the players should be in Z fashion, moving to the right from position 1. Player shall wear the proper uniform numbered 1 to 12 and numbers shall be clearly visible on both front and back. Player's uniform. All players should wear solitary colored uniform including t-shirt and shorts. All players should wear suitable sports shoes. Men and women, including boys and girls, should wear t-shirt and shorts. Each team should bear the chest number from 1 to 12 only. Size of the chest number should be 5 into 10 centimeters in the front and 10 into 20 centimeters at the back. Play. Choice of the court or service shall be decided by tossing the coin before. Soon after the referee blows the whistle, the play starts. Rotation position, order of the players shall be maintained throughout the set. Rotation position, order of the players can be changed for any subsequent sets, informing the umpire. However, in the deciding set, they shall not be changed in the position order of the players when they change the court at 13 points. During the service, players shall be in their respective positions. If any player of receiving team is not in the respective position, then the serving team will be awarded a point. If the player of the serving team is not in respective position, the team will lose service. In case players of both the teams are not in respective position, a common ball may be given. During the play, if there is any natural, unforeseen disturbance taken place, it will be considered as common ball and reservice shall be given. Service. The ball should be served using palm of any one hand from above the shoulder level in one course of action. If ball is served below the shoulder level, it is considered as foul. Player should serve the ball within 5 seconds soon after blowing the whistle from within the service area without touching or crossing the end line of the playing area. The service ball touching the net and antenna shall not be permitted and side change should be given. The service ball shall be returned by only one player of the opponent team and the second touch is not allowed. The service ball on all lines of the playing area shall be considered as good ball except box line. If the server takes more than 5 seconds to serve, then it results in delay, ball in or out. Any ball falling on any line of the playing area is a good ball except the box line. Any ball that falls into the box and on the box line is dead ball. Any ball that falls on the ground outside the playing area with or without touching the players is considered as out ball. Any ball touching the antenna is out ball. Ball in play. A player shall not take more than one step to return the ball. If so, it is called as movement and is not permitted. A player shall receive the ball with both hands and shall return the ball with only one hand. If not so, it is called as both hands throw and is not permitted. A player must have his contact with the ground while receiving the ball. A player jumping and receiving, holding the ball in the air is not permitted and it is given foul. Any player during the play shall not touch the box line. A ball in rally, which is except service ball, if slipped or dropped by a player not deliberately before touching the ground in the court, can be handled by any one of the player mate and can return it to the opposite court. Ball shall be thrown by the player above the shoulder level only. Player receiving the ball at any level above the trunk should bring it to the shoulder level and then should be released within 3 seconds in one course of action. Otherwise, it is considered as thrown below the shoulder level and foul. Ball handling. Handling of the ball. Holding the ball simultaneously by both the hands firmly is permitted. Player shall receive the ball firmly only above the trunk level. The player shall not receive the ball below the trunk level. And if so, it is not permitted and accounted as improper holding. Tapping, pushing. Tapping or pushing of the ball deliberately by the player shall not be permitted. Body touch. While throwing, the ball shall not touch any part of the body except the palm. If so, amounts to body touch. Shifting. The player shall throw the ball from the same side on which he or she receives the ball. The side changes from right to left or left to right shall not be permitted. And if so, is called shifting. Delay. Any player during the play shall not retain the ball for more than 3 seconds. Receiving and returning of the ball by the player shall be one course of action and should be completed within 3 seconds. Otherwise, it causes delay. Clash. Pulling or catching the ball by two or more players simultaneously shall not be permitted and is called as